Hi everyone, we are here at P.L. & Smith's Moss Mountain Farm. I mean, this place is absolutely stunning. It's green and wooded and just full of life. It's an absolutely gorgeous farm. We're going to learn more about improving your world today through nature's beauty and bounty here at the Garden2Grow event. And in front of me here is his house. It's gorgeous. And let's get our quick first look at it. And the front porch, I mean, don't you just want to have a cup of coffee or a glass of wine there? It's absolutely beautiful, and I'm just so excited to be here and share all of this with you on our trip. Oh, this is amazing. This is so exciting.
Nice to see you.
Hi, nice to see you.
I'm Alan Kim. Smith, nice to see you. Yeah, happy you're here.
Thank you.
All right.
This is Jerry.
Hi. Hey, Jerry.
Hi, good to be here.
Jeff, I see that.
Very nice to meet you.
Where are you all from?
We're from Southern California.
Oh,
yeah,
right. Well, welcome.
Thank you so much.
Have you ever been to Arkansas before?
No, it's our first time. We haven't been much to the South at all.
Oh, really?
So we're super excited to see it.
Such a deprived life.
I know,
well, it's time to do something about that.
Well, that's why we're here.
I love it. Yeah, excellent.
Love all the greenery and the forest and everything.
Yeah,
else.
Well, we've got that going on.
Yeah, you sure
we've
do.
We've had so much rain too. My heavens.
Oh, really?
Wish we could share it with you.
We got a little bit of yours this year, but we could use some more. That's for sure.
Always. I know. I have so many friends in California. Yeah.
Oh,
so,
do you?
So we do the taping of the show there a lot.
Yeah. Oh, you do? Where do you film there?
Well, all over. It's a big
state.
Okay,
all over the place. Absolutely. There's lots of beautiful things to film there too.
Well, there are. People love their horticulture.
Yes, they do. Right now we're on a mini tour of the farm and it's absolutely gorgeous. We're learning more about heat tolerant varieties of flowers that really stand up to the heat and the cold. And we're going to head out here to another garden area. So it's absolutely gorgeous to see the fountain, the house behind me, and in front of me is the Arkansas River. Everything is in a direct line to the house, the fountain, the river behind me. And the gardens actually on either side of the fountain are mirror images of each other. One with warm colors, one with cool colors. Oh my gosh, this is incredible. Look at these colors. I mean, what an amazing garden this is. This is like a grape arbor. The grapes are just growing up over this arbor. And the colors, the flowers are absolutely stunning. Wow, this is so amazing. We just got a tour of some absolutely gorgeous sun patience flowers. They're heat tolerant and cool tolerant. And look, big added bonus, the flowers are edible also. And this is a delicious strawberry lemonade. It's nice and warm out here. And we eat the flower and we're done.
Yeah.
Cheers. Super refreshing. Should we give this flower a go?
Oh yeah,
a must. Gotta give the flower a go because I love edible flowers. You guys know one of my favorites is nasturtiums. So I think this is going to be a new favorite in my garden. Wow, that's really good. It's actually, it doesn't have a super strong flavor. It's kind of light, refreshing, kind of juicy. It's really good. Here we are at P.L. & Smith's Organic Garden. Now this is set up to really mimic what a backyard gardener would do and really to grow things in an easy way. So we are going to head over to the carrots and these carrots are absolutely gorgeous. They're in beautiful loose soil and we're going to pull up a handful for you guys today and maybe even sample some.
Look at those Fuente carrots by Sakat. Aren't they beautiful?
Those are absolutely gorgeous.
We're going to have some for supper.
Oh really? Awesome. And it's all organic.
It's all organic. We could chew on them right now if we didn't mind a little soil.
Hey,
but that's good
hurt,
soil.
Right?
No, it's good dirt.
Good dirt, absolutely good dirt. Yeah. This is absolutely beautiful, all organic. And
indeed, yep.
Wonderful.
We planted the borders are all done for the pollinators and of course the visual candy, you know, you walk through here and you go, oh my gosh, look at all these flowers. And then we try to integrate flowers among the vegetables because it's, you know, there's a little something here for everything.
Absolutely. Yeah. I know she has some edible flowers, the nasturtiums.
Yep,
throw them in a salad.
Right, and a lot of the vegetable flowers, like the basil blooms we use, the bulldog collards by Cicada, those blooms are great. And then also we have this You can see right over there that arugula. Those people think beautiful. That just because arugula bolts and flowers, well, they got to do away with it. No, those flowers are delicious.
They're lovely. I love arugula and nasturtiums. Are some of my favorite flowers. Yeah. Add to a salad, get that peppery.
They're perfect, and the flowers are equally peppery.
Yes.
Yeah. And we use the little nasturtium buds. They can serve as a substitute for capers.
Oh,
yeah,
is that right?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, they're very good.
That.
Enjoy
Wonderful.
Your time.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay, so here is the carrot area, and these are some of the most beautiful carrots I've ever seen. Now, I've talked a lot about how carrots grow in really well in loose soil. There's amazing soil here, and they actually mulch with rice hulls, which is a really great way to do it because it breaks down really easily and adds organic matter to the soil. But here we've got carrots that are just absolutely gorgeous. I'm just going to pull me up a handful. They come up really easily. Wow, these are so pretty. Now if I could wash the dirt off and I could just take a bite right here, we actually had a chance to sample some just a little bit ago, and man, were they ever delicious. But these are some really nice looking carrots. This is absolutely stunning here. I mean, the colors just pop, and seeing all the vegetables and how they're mixed in with the flowers, I just absolutely love that. I mean, over here behind me, there's some nasturtiums, one of my favorite flowers to grow. Edible flowers, edible leaves. What a gorgeous display this is. How about watering? Like, do you have a watering schedule? How do you water? Do you use drip irrigation, or how does that work?
The water, one of the things we try to teach on the show, and we try to help with people understanding the importance of water conservation. So with the house, when we get near it, I'll talk a little bit about all the rainwater harvesting that comes off of the buildings around the house into a 6,000-gallon cistern, which is, in fact, we had breakfast just over that 6,000-gallon cistern. It's a Mr. Jefferson's Fair Mornay, the idea of having this sort of nice lawn that you can sit back and look at the cosmos from along that step, looking north was the whole idea. But under it is this 6,000-gallon cistern that we use for water. But more importantly, this levee that we'll walk across created a very deep pond, which allows us to collect water. And if we need water, we can bring it up from our wells near the river. So they're pumped up and it fills there, and then we can irrigate the gardens from that.
Okay. Yeah. Do you get enough rain usually in the summertime?
No.
You have to irrigate?
It's you know, it's comes in fits and starts.
It just depends.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so it's, you know, one year it might, you just never know. I mean, mm-hmm. this year it's been unseasonably cold, and with lots of rain, you can see the river's about to break its bank on the other side. But you know, day after tomorrow it could all dry up and it won't rain again until September, you know, so we just don't know. So we always have to be prepared for this, and I think that's the case for all of us, isn't it? What do we do with the food? Well, first of all, we grow this off for our sponsors for photography and showing how to grow these things, whether it's Bonnie or Cicada. We serve the food here, and then we share it with the men that work on the farm. And then there are two food banks, as it were, one food bank and then one institution that we work with.
The theme of the event is Improve Your World with Beauty and Bounty. And I'm telling you, that's all around us here, and we can all take action steps to do this. So that's what we're here learning all about. We just got done visiting, a quick visit at the vegetable garden that is really set up to teach home gardeners how to grow their own food in a very simple way and to make it doable for people so that you feel like you can be successful at this and have some quick, easy tips on how you can do it yourself. You don't have to have a big, huge acreage, but it's easy for anyone to grow your own food.
This idea of luring someone through the garden, wanting to know what's on the other side of that hedge, what's beyond that garden gate, what's beyond that door, is an important element of design that's I think often overlooked. So what we have here is a series of crescent containers, and I think they're very convincing in that they look like terracotta. And what we've planted in them is a series of proven winners plants from the Let's Dance series, and these are rhythmic blue, even though they're showing a little purple and pink, which simply means that for them to be bluer, what do I need to add to the soil? If I want to make them bluer, what do I need to add to the soil?
Alkaline?
Nope. Aluminum sulfate.
Okay.
Move to the front of the class, Nick. So, right, you want to make the soil more acidic, so you'd use aluminum sulfate, right?
It is dreamy. I mean, look down this pathway lined with trees. This is absolutely gorgeous. I feel like I'm in heaven. Behind me here is P. Allen Smith's set studio house that he's going to be using to film and educate people on different things about growing your own food, healthy living, healthy lifestyle. I mean, this would be so much fun to have a studio house like this. I guess that's kind of my dream, a studio house and a studio garden that we could just have set up for filming. It would be a lot of fun. Okay, we are headed to the Poultry Palace, which I'm really excited about because I've wanted to have chickens for a long time, but haven't had the time or just the space to do it. So I'm super excited to see how Poultry Palace looks and maybe get a few tips for getting a couple chickens of my own someday, hopefully. The woods are just amazing. It's thickly wooded. We just don't see this that often in California. So this is a real treat for us. I mean, I could just literally wander through those woods for an afternoon and be perfectly happy. So, so beautiful and peaceful.
These are my favorites, the golden penciled hamburgs. But these are the ones, like I said, they're very small.
Mm-hmm.
You see, they're full grown and they lay a regular size egg.
So these would be good to have in a small space?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
oh,
just
really
a
cool.
Small flock of maybe 4 to 5, no more.
Three to four or five.
Just eggs for your home,
uh-huh.
You know, just for you to consume. And it wouldn't take my little coop. The bottom, they have about 2 feet of space underneath where they sleep at night that they can go in and out. So that full 6 foot by 4 foot, they can run around in. Of course, you can let them out to free range.
Uh-huh.
But then the upper part where they walk up the steps and go inside, where they sleep at night in their roost and where their nest boxes are, is kind of up above, and it's all roofed over.
The Romans wrote about around 400 when they actually invaded what is now Spain. Right there. But this white bib makes them look like they have a white face.
So this is the part I've been waiting for, the whole event, is we get to take a tour of P. Allen Smith's house. So now we're going to go in here to the front room, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about what he has in here. So this is really exciting.
This place was part of our PBS work for about 3 seasons, I think. And we built it all green, but very much in the traditional style of what might have been here in the 1830s and 40s. So we went to a property within properties within 175-mile radius of here, looked at
we're going into the kitchen. And it's incredible. Looks like with a view overlooking the gardens and the Arkansas River Valley. I mean, this is an iconic, to me, southern porch. And the decor is just all natural, like greens and browns. Splashes of orange in here. All the succulents. I mean, this is such a peaceful place to spend an afternoon, have a cup of coffee, glass of wine, take a nap. Outdoor sleeping quarters. I mean, this is amazing. It's got outdoor bathtub at the end. It's all a screened-in porch, again, overlooking the gardens, the Arkansas River. And look at these quilts. Oh my gosh, this is absolutely beautiful.
Splashing.
Yeah. I mean, they really use these for sleeping, but you gotta see the outdoor bathtub. Look at this, a working bathtub. It's all hooked up to plumbing. Now just sitting here for a nice soak before you go to bed, relax, and then just go hop into bed. You've got the open air in front of you. What a way to sleep. I would love to do that.
Well, Kim, I hope you've had a good time.
We've had a wonderful time. Thank you so much for having us.
Well, I hope you'll come back.
Oh, we will. We'll definitely
It's been a joy having you here.
Thank you.
Well, just relax up here on this front porch and enjoy yourself, and we'll see you soon.
Okay.
All right. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. It's been a wonderful trip. What an experience to be here at Moss Mountain Farm. Meet P. Allen Smith and learn all about improving your world with beauty and bounty. I hope you guys have enjoyed yourself. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.